Vancouver, Vancouver, Fairview.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. When nitrogen levels in manure spray exceed what crops can absorb, the result is nitrate levels that continue to rise past danger levels. High nitrate levels are a serious health concern for infants less than 6 months old, for the elderly, and they can increase the risk of stomach cancer in adults. Honourable Speaker, it's been 2 years since the Environment Ministry issued a compliance order limiting the ability of H.S. Janssen and Sons Farm to apply effluent to their field. Tests from Steel Springs in December and January measured nitrate concentrations more than double the goal laid out in the original compliance order. Honourable Speaker, Spallumcheen and Halkar Valley residents, along with the Splatson First Nation, are fed up with this government's failure to protect their drinking water. They're legitimately worried about their health. To the Environment Minister, in the face of mounting evidence, why won't her government act to protect the Halkar aquifer from increasing contamination?
Minister of the Environment.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And first, let me clarify that the compliance order that was issued was not a one-time event. It was a compliance order that actually requires the person to do anything the ministry considers necessary to stop any contravention or prevent any other contravention. So it allows for ongoing powers for the ministry to act, and they have been acting. In fact, Madam Speaker, contrary to the perception that's being created, the ministry since that time has been watching very closely activity on the farm in question, and also has not, contrary to what has been insinuated, allowed for effluent spreading in some kind of an uncontrolled way, and has denied that opportunity to the operation on a number of occasions. I should make it clear, though, Madam Speaker, that this is a situation where we are advised by the experts who are with the Ministry of Health, who are with the Ministry of Environment, that through their ongoing study, they have yet to identify a specific source of the nitrate contamination. They are working very closely together with the Ministry of Agriculture in order to do that, in order to develop a long-term plan to ensure we can improve the health of the aquifer. That work is ongoing, and we are, of course, taking very seriously the impact on the health and the environment of the surrounding area.
Thank you, Minister. Member for Vancouver Fairview on a supplemental.
Honourable Speaker, the Minister of the Environment says that the Ministry is taking continuing action and that the source has not yet been identified, but it's clear from reports that there is only one farm large enough to likely be the source when the nitrogen load continues to grow and Steel Springs nitrate levels have risen 11% over the last 2 years. Honourable Speaker, residents have received help from a professional agrologist whose low-range estimate for the Janssen's farm shows an excess of nitrogen. The agrologist's comment was, and I quote, "The farmer should be nailed to the wall for what he has been doing for years." Yet this government, Honourable Speaker, not only allows the spraying of liquid manure to continue and the risk to continue to escalate, it flaunts its own information laws and forces residents to do their own water testing.
Question.
Honourable Speaker, when will the Environment Minister listen to local residents and First Nations and protect their basic right to clean, safe water?
Minister of the Environment.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And there's no question that the Ministry of Environment staff in the Regional Operations Branch have been absolutely diligent in terms of conducting their testing. They commenced monthly sampling in February of last year. Those samples have been taken once per month since. Those sample results are provided to the Steel Springs Water District within 7 days once they receive the results. If the samples exceed the Canadian drinking water guidelines, those are provided to the Ministry of Agriculture, Interior Health, and the Town of Spallumcheen. The last sample that was taken on February 23rd, the results were received from the lab on February 29th, then provided on March 7th to the Steel Springs Water Board. But, Madam Speaker, the Regional Operations Branch, and this goes to the point of can we pinpoint a source, they recently took samples from 8 sites in the Halkar Valley, provided their findings in a memo. This memo was provided to the Save Halkar Aquifer team, Chief Wayne Christian, Chief of the Splatson First Nation, Interior Health Authority, Ministry of Agriculture, and all of that is available in the Environmental Impact Assessment memo that is currently on the Ministry of Environment's website. We take this very seriously, and we will continue to do the work needed to identify the source and to deal with it.